Hello. I like to make today crunchy lemon muffins and decorate them as emlins. It's a beautiful type of muffins, very quickly mix and taste, texture and taste is great. As well as what we will do is we will actually make them in two mini muffins. Makes a little bit more cuter, and kids really love it when it's nice bite sort of size. So they don't want to have these great giant muffins that which is they have to complete and eat it basically. So they want to pick up these little things. First of all, what we have to do is we have to preheat our oven to 200 degrees Celsius. I think it's around 400 Fahrenheit, but I will write everything in the description box in Fahrenheit. And what we do is we have 24 mini muffin tray, which is I line with a different color of the paper liners. As you can see, some of them green, some of them blue, because we will decorate them into different color of emblems. You don't have to use the multicolored. If you want it, you can just use a plain one. It doesn't really matter, whatever you're able to find it. So what you do is next, to for easier to remove those muffins and easier to eat, we just slightly coat them with the cooking spray, just like this. So what we do is next, once it's all done, it's set aside. It will be nice and clean, easy to remove it. So next is we have 2 cups of self-raising flour and 3/4 cup of just a normal average sugar, which is we incorporated in our bowl, and we just with metal whisk just to kind of mix it all together. So it's all tossed and it's done. Next step is to have 75 gram of butter, which we melted. Then it's cool down, and we add 1 cup of milk, just a normal. I'm using full cream milk because it does make a difference in some recipes if you're using full cream milk. What we do is we just mix it together. Next is to add 1 egg. Mix it all together again. Just a slightly, just with fork. And we add lemon rind, grated lemon rind, of 1 large or 2 small lemons, or simply for your taste. So what we do is we place all this grated rind inside our butter mixture, and we incorporate it all nicely all together with a fork to combine. So what we do is next we add the liquid ingredients into our dry ingredients. We just make kind of like a well sort of in the middle. We pour all our dry ingredients, a liquid ingredient. To make sure we not lost any of our valuable pieces, we want it to go all in to make it beautiful, crunchy muffins. And what we do is next, we combine only until the dry ingredients have been dampened. Not too much, because muffins do not like this mix, they get tough. We don't need thoroughly mixed. So here we are, it's all done. Next step is divide it into our prepared muffin, mini muffin tray. Once we place teaspoons into our prepared mini muffin tray, which is lined with the paper liners. As you can see, we did not overload. We just placed just enough because we don't actually want it to rise too much, because we need it really actually flat. If it's anything will rise, we need flattened to make sure we create those emblems. But as you can see, we placed 24 crunchy lemon muffins, but we still have muffin butter is left. So I would say that this recipe will easily make 36 mini muffins, or was saying that it makes 12 medium size muffins, which is, I think it will make more really, even medium size. As you can see, we place 6 here from leftover muffin butter, and as you can see, it still will be more. It definitely will more than 12 medium standard size muffins, or it will be around 36 mini muffins. So we need or another tray, or just once it's baked, we just line another one if you do using mini muffin tray. So now we will place in our preheated oven to 200 degrees Celsius, which is 400 Fahrenheit. And for the standard muffins, it takes about 10 minutes, which is for mini muffins, takes about 6 to 7 or maybe 8 minutes, depends from your oven. We once it's baked, we take it out and let it cool. Now our lemon crunch muffins are cooled down. As you can see, the crumb come really nicely. If you do not fill up too much paper case, they will not rise extremely much, so you have less to trim. This one is, which is in a standard muffin tray was, so you can use mini or standard, doesn't really matter, it's of your choice. So what we do is basically, say for example, this is our ready lemon muffin. So you don't want to trim too much, really. Probably best for the result if you trim it just same level as a paper case, because it's easier to decorate it. But you don't really want to waste too much kind of a good muffin. So what you do is, with a nice serrated knife, you just simply trim it, just stop to just what part it's only rise, just like this. And we can use that. As you can see, it's still ours. Make sure we not waste too much of a good muffin. So what we do is next, we're using vanilla frosting. If you like it to create a little bit more flavor in it, just place vanilla frosting with a small amount of a tiny, maybe lemon juice or lemon zest. If you like it to do so, mix it together, and we will use it for spreading. We don't need really much, we just need very small amount to just make sure fondant is stick. Because it tastes already really good. So next is, we're using a different color fondant. You can use as many colors as you wish. You can make rainbow emblems or basically any colors, because it comes with so many beautiful various colors. And if you don't have particular right color of fondant, simply use a type of gel food coloring like Americola or Wilton. Americola easy to apply because you just can squeeze it, get any colors what you like. Just buy white fondant and tint it into various colors with various gel food coloring. See, I tinted just a minute ago this one with the blue gel food coloring, because I did not have it any of blue fondant. So once you start rolling, if your working surface is stick, what you do is apply very small amount of powdered sugar or icing sugar. It's really something. And what we do is we just roll into, it just depends how many you're going to decorate as well. And here we are. Now, next is we using a small cookie cutter. I got it one of this kind of packet. I got the smallest one. How you will know, once you take your, you will see how far you will actually get a fondant cut. So this is perfect, which is small, and this is 48 millimeters or 1 7/8 of inches. I will write everything in the description box. I always do. So we cut it out. As you can see, we have nice, good round shape. And what we do is next, we simply pinch where is we want to have it. Little ease and little fit, just like this. Very, very simple. So what we do is next, we use toothpick, and we just simply draw out areas. It just look like will be like a few sort of, just on areas. So we go right around, right everywhere. And what we do is we just create a little bit more kind of triangular shape, more around the ease. Just a fiddle with a fondant until you create until you create a shape what you really like to see. You can make them long or all round. If you like to have a long one, just to make prolonged shape and just place it. It still goes very well with this kind of, you just have prolonged shapes, that's all. It does not make any difference. Here our little feet. And as you can see, we created basically shape of our emblem. So, what we do is now, we just simply place on top of our prepared and frosted muffin. We just place very small amount of frosting, but that's enough. It keeps muffins also nice and moist as well. So it's kind of has various good things about it. So here we are. We created little tiny shape of emblem. So next is what we use for the eyes. It's an edible confetti, pastel confetti. They can be purchased in a supermarket. As you can see, they come in various colors. We're using white. And with a small brush and tiny amount of water, just apply where is you want to place the eyes. Take two white confettis. And here they are. So next is basically I using a packet of food edible decorating paint. It can be purchased from various decorating shops or online, or it's plenty online. It's very easy to use one of those because they do write very well, and also they edible as well, which is very, very important. And if you cannot find those, what you do is use simply writing icing, various writing icing, small comes in packets or larger ones. These ones you can purchase in a supermarket, and it does not need any nozzle. If you use one of those Wilton ones, you use a tip 2, very, very small, or even tip 1 to create this little tiny miniature patterns of emblems. And what we do is next, we simply just create different various patterns of a different emblem. So here our eyebrows, we won't make them same color as emblem. So we're using same color black ed, sorry, same color edible food decorating pen, and once you draw, they come a little bit darker. That's what we really wanted. Here we are. So once we done that, basically that's how our emblem is look like. So what we do is we just have a look on the various expressions, and as I said to you before, you can definitely use different colors. It's so many of them. It's just such a great decoration because you can use various colors. And if you're using this edible confetti, as you can see, they come in different colors as well. So it's just great. You can actually kind of make it really, really fun to do with your child. As you can see, for the purple, we have a little tiny kind of like a tease. So I use the white sprinkles, which is I use, of course, tiny ones. And what you do is apply with little tiny tweezers, kitchen tweezers, keeping them in the kitchen clean, and place for this little tiny kind of tease to make it really, really funny. Well, everything will be in the description box. I hope you do like this sort of decoration of emblems. Thank you very much for your time with me today. Until next time, goodbye.